Hello friends, welcome to Online GS, and we are continuing our series on Indian river systems presented to you by me, Abhinav Raj. See, this is the part 2 of Narmada river system. In the part 1, we have already talked about its origin, nomenclature, its flow in concerned states including Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Gujarat, important plains, mountain ranges associated with the Alia bed, important tributaries including what a left bank tributary, a right bank tributary is, Omkareshwar Island, everything. And in this video we are going to start with important cities on the bank of river Narmada. These cities include Mandla, Jabalpur, Hoshangabad, Mandhata, Omkareshwar, Maheshwar, Dharampuri, Barwaha, Barwani, Rajpipla and Bharuj. But it's a hard nut to crack if you start remembering these cities like this. So a map makes understanding of geographical locations very easy. So let's tune to map. See, this is the Narmada river in blue color, and this is Mandla, this is Jabalpur, and this is Hoshangabad. But what is important, you have to know on which side bank, that is right bank or on the left bank, a city is located. See, this is Narmada and the Mandla is located in north of Narmada river, Jabalpur in the north, Hoshangabad in the south. But if you are asked in terms of right and left bank, so you have to decide this is the direction of flow of river, and anything in our right hand side is the right bank and on the left hand side is left bank. So Mandla and Jabalpur are right bank tributary, where and Hoshangabad is left bank. Sorry, Mandla and Jabalpur are right bank city and Hoshangabad is left bank city, not tributary. See, this is Mandhata. Mandhata is an island, so it is neither a left bank city nor a right bank city. It is in the mid of the river, where Omkareshwar is on its left bank, Maheshwar and Mandaleshwar on its right bank, Dharampuri on right bank, Barwani on the left bank, Rajpipla on the left bank and Bharuch on the right bank or in the north of the river. Okay, see, in this map of India we can see this is Mandla, Jabalpur, Hoshangabad, Omkareshwar, this is Dharampuri, this is Barwani, Rajpipla and Bharuj. Okay, Narmada basin, it is hemmed between the Bindh and Satpura range, lying on the northern extremity of the Deccans. We have already talked about the Deccans and its location with respect to Narmada in our first part, so you can watch the first part to understand this part in better way. And the basin of Narmada is composed of states including Maharashtra 81%, Gujarat 12%, 4% in Maharashtra, 2% in Chhattisgarh and 1% in Andhra Pradesh. So this is very interesting. No one will think that Narmada basin includes a state of Andhra Pradesh, but it includes 1%. But it is, this is very important, that Andhra Pradesh is related to Narmada basin. And the Dhupgarh, that is 1350 meter high of Satpura range, is the highest peak of the Narmada basin as well as of Madhya Pradesh. And Panchmadhi, a hill station, is located close to this peak, and it is also located in Narmada basin. See, this is the map of Madhya Pradesh, and the districts including Shahdol, Mandla, Balaghat and Sioni. These are known as upper hilly areas, and Sagar, Damoh, Jabalpur, Narsimhpur, Chindwara, Betul, Hoshangabad, Raisen and Shivhar, that is the middle zone. This is known as the upper plain, and the districts demarcated in green including Indor, Dhar, Khargone, Khandwa, Devas, these are known as middle plains. Whereas Jhabua, Nimar, Dhule from Maharashtra and Gujarat districts including Vadodara, Narmada and Bharuch, these compose the lower hilly regions, and lower plains include Vadodara, Narmada and Bharuch, that is the three districts of Gujarat. See, the middle zone, that is the upper plain and the middle plain in blue and green color, is the productive zone having the fertile plains, and in the starting or in the upper course and in the end of the course there are, you can say, hilly terrains, and in its lowest course, that is in Vadodara, Narmada and Bharuch, there are little bit plains. Narmada basin is mainly composed of black soil because it is related to Deccan, and Deccan is made up of basalt, and basalt is black colored soil, clay soil. And it's in coastal areas, that is in the Gujarat side, it is alluvial clay plus black soil layer. Okay. The geology. The Narmada Valley is a graben. What a graben is? It's a geological term. And two normal faults known as the Narmada North Fault and Narmada South Fault. And these are parallel to the river. Several dinosaur fossils have been found in areas including the Titanosaurus indicus, in which was discovered in 1877, and the study of the fossils of dinosaur is known as paleontology. So let's understand what a graben is, what a fault is. Okay, so let's see. This is the Bindh and this is Satpura, and the river flowing is Narmada. We are going to discuss what a fault and rift valley, graben, everything. See, suppose these were all equal or having the same height, but anyhow the fault develops, normal faults here and here, the faults have developed, and with some of the geological causes, some light think that here the basement is weak, so this portion of the rock mass comes down, so this is the lower in comparison to the up region sides. On its both sides, the uplifted part is known as the horst, and the downward or which has gone down is known as the graben. Okay, and these cracks, the developed areas of cracks, are known as the faults. See here, this is Bindhya and this is Satpura. These are horsts, or you can say Bindhya horst, Satpura horst, and this is the Narmada graben, and these are faults. The one in on the side of Bindhya is known as the Northern Narmada fault, and on the Satpura side it is known as the Southern Narmada fault. Okay, and the river flowing in this is known as rift valley. So it is always said that Narmada river flows through a rift valley. Do you know now what a rift valley is? Historical and cultural aspects of Narmada river. The Kannada emperor from the Chalukya dynasty, that was Pulakesin II, has said to be defeated the Harshvardhan, the last Hindu emperor of the ancient India of Kannauj, on the bank of river Narmada. And the gorgeous Maheshwari saris, which are hand woven, comfortable in warm as well as in cold weather, dressy and light weighted, are also very famous, and this is the cultural aspect of the Narmada river basin. See, this is the Maheshwari sari. Forests of Narmada basin. Teak and India's best hardwood forest are found in the Narmada river basin. The lower Narmada river valley has dry deciduous rain forests, and these forests get water from the southeast monsoons. The ecoregion is home of 76 species of mammals, 276 bird species, and this is interesting that none of them is endemic, that is no one is from the specific location of Madhya Pradesh. All these are exotic varieties. National parks in Narmada river basin include the Kanha National Park in Kanha district of Madhya Pradesh, and The Jungle Book by Rudyard Kipling has been written about this national park, and it is one of the most important national parks of Asia. The other one is Satpura National Park in Hoshangabad district. Mandla Plant Fossil National Park and Dindori Fossil National Park. These are related to the fossils. Panchmadhi Biosphere Reserve in Hoshangabad district. Stulpaneswar Sanctuary, famous for sloth bear, in Narmada district of Gujarat and Nandurbar district of Maharashtra. Okay, see, in this map, this is Amarkantak, the place of origin of Narmada River, and this is Amarkantak National Park, Dindori and Mandla Fossil National Parks, this is Kanha National Park, okay, this is Hoshangabad, and this is Panchmadhi Biosphere Reserve, and this is Satpura National Park, this is Nandurbar in Maharashtra, and this is Rajpipla, the administrative headquarter of Narmada district, and these areas compose Stulpaneswar Wildlife Sanctuary, which is very popular for sloth bear in India. And see, this is Ratapani in Raisen district. We will discuss about this Ratapani in Raisen district in coming slides. Okay, the flora include sal, teak, tendu, aula, mahua, bel and bamboo, and many other grasses and medicinal plants. Okay, fauna includes tiger, leopard, sambar, chital, vedki, nilgai, four-horned antelope, chinkara, bison, that is indigenous gaur, the Indian bison, wild boar, wild dogs, bear, black buck, fox, popu pine, that is also known as sahil in Hindi, flying squirrel, mouse deer, and Indian giant squirrel. Okay, anthropological and archaeological sites. The Bhim Petika, very famous, all those who are aspiring for UPSC and other public services exams will know definitely what is Bhim Petika, and this is Bhim Petika in Raisen district. Okay, and this is located inside the Ratapani Wildlife Sanctuary, and this is a rock shelter are located in dikes of Narmada Valley. You can see the picture. The walls of these caves contain prehistorical paintings. See, this is very important. These are prehistorical paintings which certified that prehistoric people existed in India. Now, the dams on Narmada River. The largest dam on Narmada River is Sardar Sarovar Dam, and it is a gravity dam located in Tapi district of Gujarat. See, this is interesting. Sardar Sarovar Dam is located on Narmada River and in Tapi district of Gujarat. It is the largest project on Narmada River. It serves two purposes, for the production of electricity as well as irrigational purposes. The next is Indira Sagar Dam in Khandwa, Madhya Pradesh. The Indira Sagar project at Mansua is one of the 30 major projects proposed on Narmada River basin, and it has the largest water storage capacity in the whole of country, and its downstream projects include Omkareswar, Maheswar and Sardar Sarovar Dam project. Okay, in this map you can see this is Khandwa and this is Indira Sagar Dam, this is Sardar Sarovar Dam in Songad is the administrative headquarter of Tapi district, and this is Hoshangabad, and this is Tawa Reservoir, the place where Tawa River meets Narmada, somewhere here near Hoshangabad. Okay, now a very important topic from the perspective of men's writings, this is the Narmada Bachao Andolan. The Narmada Bachao Andolan is a social movement which consists of Adivasis, farmers, environmentalists and human rights activists, which was against the construction of a number of large dams on Narmada River, which flows through the states of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra, and their focal point was the Sardar Sarovar Dam. Why this was why there was so much protest about the construction of dam when these dams serve so many purposes? Because these dams caused the relocation of people in the states of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. Many people lost their agricultural lands, homes, settlements. So there was a huge protest, and the campaign include court action, hunger strike, rallies, garnering support from notable film and art personalities. And the main leaders or spokesperson of Narmada Banchao Andolan include Medha Patekar and Baba Amte. Okay, and who have received Right Livelihood Award in 1991. Now, as we all know that rivers in India or river water in India is a state list subject, and so every state fights with the neighboring state for the river water. That is, the lower riparian river state always complains that upper riparian state is not fulfilling its demands, and so like all the rivers, the Narmada water dispute is very famous. And to get rid of this, the government established the Narmada Water Dispute Tribunal, and the verdicts of the tribunal was that Madhya Pradesh will get 57% water share, Gujarat 16%, Maharashtra 27%, and Rajasthan has no share. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you like my video, just give me a like button, hit, and subscribe, share, and give your honest feedbacks so that I can improve my videos. Okay, thank you.